Well, if you're like me, you're tired of hearing European leaders pile on Israel. In the eyes of many in Brussels, Israel can do nothing right. That's why Jose Maria Aznar is saying enough. I recently sat down with the former Spanish president to discuss his new Friends of Israel initiative. It's a global movement that's long overdue. Check it out. When Israeli commandos boarded a ship full of anti-Israel activists and Islamic terrorists earlier this year, the world erupted in protest, not against the ship's occupants or the Turkish government that sponsored them, but against Israel. It was the same story in 2009, when Israel struck back against Hamas terrorists in Gaza. The UN issued a report soon after, roundly condemning Israel's actions.
The guilty is Israel. Always against Israel is not true.
It's clear that Israel could use a few friends on the world stage, and the former president of Spain has answered the call. Jose Maria Aznar told CBN News recently about his new initiative called Friends of Israel. It's an international effort that includes the former presidents of Peru and the Czech Republic. They've come together to defend Israel's right to exist.
You've said if Israel goes down, we all go down. Explain what you mean by that.
If Israel is a part of the Western world, if the Western world is eliminated of this part of the world, this is a problem for all of us, not only for the Israel. Will be a great victory for the enemies of democracy, of the enemies of freedom.
Aznar says that in addition to sharing a common foe in radical Islam, Israel and the West also share common values.
Talk about what Israel has meant. Israel and the Jewish people have meant historically to Western civilization.
I cannot explain Europe. I cannot explain my country. I cannot explain myself without reference to this heritage. They share with us the same values: freedom, democracy, tolerance, pluralism.
Why do you think there's such, in many cases, anti-Israel sentiment in the UN, in some European nations? How can we explain that?
Well, the world is complicated. Trying to isolate Israel is not a good policy. And to demonize always Israel is not a good policy. Enough is enough.
Several U.S. lawmakers recently endorsed Friends of Israel. Aznar expects the group to continue to grow, with the threat posed to Israel by a nuclear Iran increasingly at the forefront.
If the West doesn't stand together with Israel, do you feel like we are in a real danger of seeing Iran possibly acquire nuclear weapons?
We have lost a lot of time. We have lost a lot of time. We have West a lot of time. And the situation now is more complicated. But it's necessary to promote two policies, trying to avoid for politically, economically, diplomatically, for international pressure, that Iran become a nuclear power. And secondly, to promote a change of regime in Iran.
Jose Maria Aznar is a man of strength and conviction, two qualities that are so lacking today in Europe in the face of the Islamic threat. If you take one thing from this interview, take this: if Israel goes down, we all go down.